Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Find the last part, part 4 of the video titled The Sexodus, The Men Giving Up on Women and Checking Out of Society. Author Milo Yiannopoulos, published originally by Breitbart.com. It not just video games and casual sex that young men are retreating into. They are also immersing themselves in fetishes that to their grandparents' generation would resemble grounds for incarceration, and which drive them further away from the formerly fairer sex. Consider, for example, the example of furry culture and anthropomorphic animal sex fetishism, both of which are experiencing explosive growth, fueled by the Internet. Jack Rivlin's student newspaper The Tab, which we encountered in Part 1, has noticed the trend spreading on UK campuses. It already rife throughout the US. Other alternative sexual behaviors, including homosexuality and transgenderism, are more prevalent on campus now too. It eminently plausible that there are a greater number of people who identify as homosexual, bisexual or other sexualities who are happy to be labeled as such these days, agrees Cambridge Union President Tim Squirrel, from whom we heard in part 1, speaking about the students he sees passing through his union. I think we are becoming more open and accepting of people who live different kinds of lifestyles and have different kinds of identities. Gay emancipation, of course, may not have been a uniformly good thing for women. Depending on whose figures you believe and you are wise not to take the claims of gay advocacy groups or gay magazines too seriously, for obvious reasons somewhere between 1% and 10% of the adult male population is gay. It probably a lot closer to 1%. Just a few decades ago, many of those men at the risk of stereotyping, the most sensitive, artistic, attractive and highest earning men, that is, perfect husband material, would have got married, had a few kids and led a double life to pursue their forbidden urges. They would and have bothered their wives for sex and they would have made great fathers. But now they are settling down with men, in many cases not having children at all. In other words, a healthy chunk of the most desirable men who no doubt would have cooed along approvingly to feminist exhortations are now off the market, leaving even fewer eligible men in the dating pool. As a side note, here an argument you won't read elsewhere: gay men test significantly higher, on average, for IQ, and we know that IQ is at least partially genetically determined. Gays don't reproduce as much now they don't have to keep up the pretense of straight relationships. In fact, surveys say they barely reproduce at all. Is it too much of a stretch to ask whether society's newfound tolerance of homosexuals has made society, well, a bit more stupid? Granted, it sounds far-fetched. But while there's no doubt that liberating gay men from the shame of their secret double lives has been a moral imperative, driven by compassion, no rapid social change comes without trade-offs. All this comes before we even discuss the rapid growth of sadomasochistic sex among the young and the new civil rights frontier of transgenderism, a psychiatric disorder currently in the process of being repackaged by the left as an alternative sexual lifestyle. The response to part 1 of this series was colossal. To date, over 300,000 readers have shared it on Facebook. 16,500 readers left comments. Over 500 men wrote to me privately to express their gratitude and support, from every continent and in all age groups. The younger men spoke especially movingly. Predictably, hundreds of angry feminists on Twitter scorned it as entitled winging from white male man bubbies, rather proving the point of the story premise for me. Here are the most representative quotes from my conversations, reprinted with permission. Mark, 24, everyone I know feels the same. Your article spoke directly to us. We not all losers and nerds, We just normal guys who are either scared of being accused of terrible stuff by harpies or simply can't be bothered anymore. I can't believe I saying this, but I just can't deal with hassle of women anymore. Mickey, I say no to the whole thing. Even though I am very heterosexual and would like the intimacy of a relationship based on mutual respect. Well, I thought I did, but it'd been so long and the standard of behavior for women remains so low, along with my tolerance for dating bullshit, that it does not look like a realistic desire anymore. Francis, 28, I am an athlete. My parents have a lot of money. I have plenty of friends and a good social life. I don't hang out with women anymore. Occasionally I'll have one night stands, but mostly I fill my time with other things. I got accused of molesting a girl at college and since then I just thought, whatever. I play sports instead. Tylo, 20. I don't know for sure, but your article sounds like me and a lot of my friends. I do furry stuff online in secret. I'd be horrified if my parents found out, but it all that gets me off. Girls are a nightmare. I have a brother who 10 years older and he feels the same. We given up. Hector, 26. I did stick to that social belief for a brief time thinking that the need for a serious relationship would come with the age. But it never happened and slowly I gave up. Today, a few hours before reading your article, I was having lunch with my mother and she kept talking about girlfriends and how I needed to get married. Meanwhile I kept thinking, how would I waste my life with this shit? And it was and until I read your article a few hours later, that I realized. And I don't think it just my generation that is affected by this. We can be quite sure now that the Sexodus is not some fringe, isolated internet movement as men going their own way has sometimes been characterized. A combination of disastrous social engineering, special privileges for women, the relentless mockery of white men on the basis of their sex and skin color and the economic and educational abandonment for boys has created one, if not two, lost generations already. Men created most of what is good about the world. The excesses of masculinity are also, to be sure, responsible for much of what is bad. But if we are to avoid sliding into decline, mediocrity and a world in which men are actively discriminated against, we must arrest the decline in social attitudes towards them before so many victims are claimed that all hope of reconciliation between the sexes is lost. If that happens, it will be women who will suffer.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.